I have a favor to ask. Just a small favor, really. Do you remember the dagger you gave me?
The dagger stabbed into the Reaver's back? His own son killed him? Yeah, I haven't forgotten that one.
Well, I traced it to a group of Reavers that operate out of the Northree stronghold. I'd wager that's where they took their haul from Fafnir's storeroom, along with that whetstone that I could use to help you.
Another treasure hunt? Pointless.
Well, not if Sindri really can make us better equipment with that whetstone. Plus, the Reaver's son, he murdered. Mir, there was a shrine about a giant lady. Lots of books and visions.
Ah, that would be Gloa, the knowledge Gloa.
She was a gifted sorceress who gathered every tome of arcane wisdom she could find in the realms, all in the hopes of augmenting her powers of prophecy that she might find her lost husband, Aurvandil. But it was not her husband she would glimpse in her visions. For it was Gloa, seeing longer and farther than any before or since, who witnessed Ragnarok, the end and the beginning. Or I can just tell you the story later.
Bofar. Frim.
Are you okay?
No, son. My goods are underwater. My men are drowned, and yet their bodies continue to walk the beaches.
Hellwalkers. They plague these lands.
I was their captain. They died because of me. But these abominations sully their memories. I will find a way to free them from their tortured state. In this, I am determined. The thunderstorm scattered all three of my ships across the lake.
Yeah.
these bones pulse with magic.
It must be Golvi. Could we just hold on to it? Maybe we'll find the rest of them.
Your spirit lies to you, boy.
How would you know?
I have known many spirits. They are all liars.
This one is different. I know it.
You know very little. Spirit to keep its word is foolish, boy.
But if there's even a chance, don't you want to see Mom again?
Of course I. She is gone, Atreus. You must accept this.
I do, but to see her again, just one more time.
Why do you believe him? You do not know him or who he was. All of this is sinister.
He wants to see someone he loved again. I understand how that feels. I don't think there's anything sinister about it.
Hope is blinding your instincts, boy. Boy, over here.
Yes, sir. Golvi's bones.
What will you say to her?
To Golvi?
Your mother. What have you left unsaid?
I just want to know if she's okay.
She is dead, boy.
I know that. You don't understand.
Neither do you.
Maybe I can fly.
No! Gods too must stay on the path, I promise you.
So what do you think, Mimir? What does Baldur want with us?
Well, let's look at what we know. Baldur is Odin's finest tracker, bar none. If he wants you, you have to consider the possibility that Odin wants you. And as for what Odin wants, on this I have some expertise.
What could we have that Odin doesn't? He's like the king of gods.
Of the Aesir, aye. But his reach is not unlimited. And where he cannot reach, he is preoccupied with going. He certainly tortured me enough about it over the years. The name of one of the Valkyries. That's quite curious.
You said him.
Nothing.
Nothing?
There is nothing left to say.
What about everything we've done so far? That man coming to the house? Talking to the world serpent? We've done so many amazing things. I just want to tell her about them. Don't you?
What would you say to her?
I tell her that we're both okay. Not to worry about us.
Atreus, I miss her too. You know this.
I thought I knew very little.
The final bone.
Yeah.
We might as well return them to the spirit. Maybe he will keep his word.
I know she's not coming back, okay? No. I just... Oh, my.
Watch your back! Come on, get up, brother!
Yeah!
piece of the language cipher.
Good.
Right then, where were we? Ah yes, Roa the Knowledge Keeper sought out her husband in visions, but instead discovered Ragnarok.
We have collected the rest of your woman's corpse spirit. Show us this magic you have promised.
Ah, my sweet Gulvig. Whole again. Rise, dear Gulvig. Awaken, O powerful Gulvig!
Erni bukar birthiast.
She says she'll honor our request.
Erdi fagnar.
And reunite us?
In Gowder!
Okay, you were right.
I'll take that!
Almost ready!
I told you so.
You are naive, foolish boy.
This is true as well. But do not take your disappointment out on me, boy. Take it as a lesson.
Yes, Sarah.
Thank you.
Right then, where were we? Ah, yes. Groa, the Knowledge Keeper, sought out her husband in visions, but instead discovered Ragnarok. Then Odin caught word of her ultimate prophecy. He maneuvered to obtain her knowledge and hoard it for himself. Groa knew Odin as a longtime patron of his services, and so she welcomed him into her library as a friend. What she did not know is that Odin himself was behind her husband's disappearance, having used his enchantments to conceal his death at Thor's hands from her sight. Smiling, jealous Odin took her by the throat, and with his very hands he stole her library and her life for his own. I'll just tell you the story later.
My father's grave lies on an island to the east. Do not mistake my mother's statue of Thor with that monstrous eyesore to the south.
glad I'm on your side.
I cannot rest while my mother's murderer stands above my father's grave.
Finish that story you started?
Odin schemed to capture the visions of Ragnarok recorded by Groa, the Knowledge Keeper.
I always knew Odin was bad. That's just...
ruthless? Barbaric? Heartless? That's Odin. In fact, we would do well to sit here in silence for the next few moments and reflect on Odin's capacity for cruelty. And so...
reflect longer.
Got him!
Oh, no.
I have a question. If Ymir was the first giant, where did he come from?
In the beginning, there was Gnungagap, the Great Void. There were no realms yet, only primordial forces. There was fire, and there was ice. And there in the void, they met and produced. Or I can just tell you the story later. Right then, we were in the middle of a story, weren't we? Regarding Ymir. Primordial fire and ice met in the Great Void, producing water.
Water?
More than water. The mystic lifeblood of something entirely new. From this water, Ymir took form and became a being of pure creation and chaos, mother and father to all that came after. You know what? I'll tell this one later.
Hey, Brock. You found something interesting.
Did you now? Well, color me interested. Tyr would have been pleased as peaches knowing these offerings were being turned to armor.
Did you know him? What was he like?
Never you mind, boy. Tyr's dead. Best not to dig up the past.
The dwarf speaks wisely, for once.
Hey, look who's back up and about. Didn't I tell you he'd be fine? Don't be letting that spit-fister of a brother of mine lay hands on it again. Something for the boy? Now there's something else.
Finish that story you started?
I can indeed. Where were we? Oh. In the year the first giant had emerged from the void, and every form of life began to spring forth from in here.
What?
His father's grave. Find anything good?
Perhaps.
Father, we're going to bring down that statue, right?
traps do not fall this easily, boy.
I know. I know. I was just joking.
Nor are they a joking matter.
Sorry.
Follow me, Atreus.
I'm on way.
Here. Boy.
Sir. Interesting.
Huh!
Father, why do the gods cause so much trouble for mortals?
Because that is their nature.
But with all that power, you would think at least some of them would try to make life better for people.
And yet, the gods continue to spread misery. This is life, boy.
Well, at least we're doing some good, right?
I need that alchemist for something I'm stewing up for you. If you're smart, you'll find him.
That story you started?
I can indeed. Where were we? In the year the first giant had emerged from the void, and every form of life began to spring forth from Ymir.
Even the Aesir?
Aye. Every god, man, and beast came first from Ymir's flesh. Though it was the Aesir who thought themselves so superior that they should hold dominion over the rest of creation. It was Odin who took arms against his creator and spilled Ymir's lifeblood with his spear. A necessary evil, he would say, to bring order to the realms. With Ymir's torn flesh, Odin would fashion the realm of Midgard for his own. Called himself All-Father, as if he was the creator and not the creator's destroyer. A small, covetous tyrant.
Ymir?
Huh? Oh, sorry, my boy. You know, I think at best we just end it there, actually.
Did you see something out there? That tower?
I see no tower.
Maybe I'm seeing things.
Thank you. Boy.
Interesting.
You scare up that alchemist, what needed finding?
Oh, almost forgot. Brock, this is our new friend Mimir.
We've met.
Oh, why didn't you say so?
He knows why. I know why. You know why.
Quiet. No more of this.
Know what? Sorry I brought it up. Said his friend was dwarven, like wearing a green ring.
Look if you wish. I will be gathering resources for our journey.
Don't want to help him?
No.
Why not?
Because I do not run errands for dwarves.
Oh. Dwarven, but no ring. One of his crew?
Scorch marks. There, along the floor and wall.
Weird. I guess we keep looking. I'll keep looking. If that kills us, that's it. No Valhalla, no hell, no afterlife, ever.
It does not attack.
Ah. Mom made them sound more dangerous than that.
Then do not drop your guard. Come.
Yes, sir.
Another map.
Severed hand
attached to the Soul Eater.
Well, we know what happened to Invari now. We can just go tell Brock. No need to fight it, right?
No, we will fight it.
Why?
Because you are frightened of it. Strong, Atreus. Stay focused and look for a weak point.
Yes, sir.
Stay quiet. Make no sudden movement. Most likely.
Soul Eater got him. I guess we should bring this back to Rock.
Can you read it?
Yes, sir. These runes were written fast. It spells out... Eugene Staney. I don't know that one.
We will ask the blue one.
So now you're interested?
We found his alchemist. A reward he promised.
So bad.
what you find.
What does it say?
Sir. These runes read death inside.
You're an alchemist.
I'm sorry, Brock. The hand is all we could find. Still wearing the ring. There was a soul eater inside, and well, he must have burned away the rest of him.
Suppose you'll still be wanting some compensation, huh?
Naturally.
Naturally, he says. Miani Feruxi. I'll take a closer look at this here ring. Maybe Anvari left a bit of magic inside before he groped.
Dwarves can do that?
Sure, dwarves and magic jewels is like flies and pigs.
Ugh. I'm not as interested as I thought.
Good choice. About that other thing.